Marine biology fact of the day. Today we're going to be talking about one of the scariest creatures in the entire Amazon River. And it's not a piranha and it's not a giant catfish. It's actually a parasite called the candiru. Now, this guy is a parasitic species of catfish that can only get a couple inches in length, but what he can do will fucking rock you. So this guy loves to eat blood. He's basically a vampire. And what he does is he smells certain chemicals in the water to hunt. And these chemicals are usually ammonia and urea, which are released by fish, but also by humans when we pee. And this guy is known to swim up the urethra of men and women who pee in the Amazon, and then he emits those razor sharp little gill spikes, latches them into your area, and then sucks your blood, and he can't swim back out, so he dies, and you have to get surgery to remove him, and here's an x-ray. This is terrifying. Do not ever pee in the Amazon anywhere. They are so scary. Yes, the penis fish, the candiru. Google it as you wish. Boom. Four crazy shark superpowers. Number one, they rarely get sick. Yes, sharks have superior immune systems, mostly due to their tissue, which is very unique in that it has antibacterial and anticoagulant properties that scientists are actually trying to study and synthesize to cure our own human diseases. Number two, they have a super sense of smell. Due to something called an olfactory bulb, which is a special type of sensory organ in a shark's body, they have an amazing sense of smell, can smell one drop of blood for every 25 gallons of water sometimes, or even smell blood up to a mile away. That doesn't mean they're gonna eat you though. Number three, they have something called electrosensitivity. Due to a specific type of organ called the ampullae of Lorenzini, which are gel-filled pores all along their nose and their lateral line, they can detect organisms just to an electromagnetic field they put off into the water. Number four, they never run out of teeth. Basically, sharks have enough teeth to last them their entire lifetime and then some due to something called a tooth conveyor belt. Basically, they have multiple rows of teeth, and due to a soft tissue type of conveyor belt, it just pushes up the new teeth every time they lose one.
Ate ko ba hari kita nak cakap pasal bunyi anak krokodil.
Okey, mak bapak krokodil punya bunyi, mak bapak, iya ke? Ya, yang dewasa punya bunyi, saya rasa kita dah boleh expect ke bunyi ni macam mana. Jom kita dengar.
Kian, anak dia punya bunyi pula totally different, 180 degree berbeza banding dengan mak bapak dia. Sebab anak dia ni nampaklah muka dia pun comel kan, anyet cececec, bunyi dia pun comel. Yeah, serius ni bunyi dong, macam bunyi laser. Lagi pun bila bawa mic macam ni, dia orang ingat dia orang like cyber ke apa. Comel.
Whatever you do, don't freak out. We were all females at some point in our lives. The Y chromosome in boys doesn't develop till about 5 weeks after conception. When it does, the ovaries descend and become the testes, and the labia fuses to create the scrotum, leaving a line. It's also the reason why men have nipples. They form before the Y chromosome is activated. If you want to see this for yourself, download the crazy baby game. Links in my bio, it's so cool.
Sami Jabi action nazywa. Biologicznie. Halo, proszę pani, jak się nazywa samiec żaby?
Proszę?
Jak się nazywa samiec żaby?
A nie wiem.
O, masz. To pani wykłada na uniwersytecie czy kafelki w toalecie?
Ale samca żaby to my nie wiemy, jak się nazywa.
A samica żaby jak się nazywa?
A żaba to jest samica.
A on?
A on to będzie żabiec.
Kurwa, na żabę. Żabiec?
No, jak?
A jak będą dwa żabce i jedna żabica? To co będzie wtedy? Trójkąt.
Będzie trójkąt.
No widzisz, wermucki. Panie, skupia, widzisz.
So I got Venomous Green Mamba into the tube, but how the herp do I get him out of there? No worries, I will show you in this video, no part 2 necessary. But first I want to talk about why snakes and lizards have two penises. Well, not penises exactly, but hemipenes. In yesterday's video I showed you the cloaca of a black mamba, and cloaca is basically the reptile and bird equivalent to an anus, but besides being the source of snake defecation, it is also where the reproductive organs are kept. I'm not sure if I can show you a snake penis on TikTok, so here are some CNN- and then the thing that Nemo lives in instead, which are really close representations for what they actually look like. This shed skin is from one of our rattlesnakes, and you can actually see evidence of both hemipenes on it. But why do they have two? Efficiency, that's why. Snakes and lizards have one testy dedicated to each hemipenis, which means if a male snake gets the chance to successfully mate and then gets another chance to do it again right after, he has another hemipenis and testy already ready to go. And researchers have been able to observe that snakes will switch which hemipenis they use between mating sessions. And if you think that's crazy, follow for tomorrow's video on the all-female species of lizard.
Big Bird has forward-facing eyes, suggesting he is a predator. This statement is true. Most predators do have their eyes in the front of their head. See, having eyes on the side of your head lets you see predators coming, gives you a better chance of surviving. But forward-facing eyes give you two superpowers. First off, it gives you better depth perception, whether that's a tiger jumping for its prey or an eagle swooping down. But the second superpower that front-facing eyes gives you is something that we use every day without even thinking about it. Us predators have X-ray vision. You don't believe me? Take your finger right now and put it in front of your face, and guess what? You can see straight through that finger and keep watching me on the screen. This enables predators, especially in forests, to see through trees and leaves to reach their prey. There are definitely exceptions to this rule, sloths, for example. But if we're just talking about probability, Big Bird is most likely the apex predator of Sesame Street.
Gonna bring your best friend too.
Michael Jackson, I'ma beat it. Game undefeated. She look good in that bikini, but the winter time my favorite season. She gon' drop it in reverse. I merely rock it in reverse.
Anda kamu perasan tak selalunya kucing yang dah dewasa dia tak mengiau satu sama lain? Heh? Sebab, according to research, kucing hanya mengiau kalau mak dia nak cari anak dia ataupun anak dia nak cakap beritahu something pada mak dia. Tapi between cats, kucing tak mengiau tau. Jadi perasan, kalau kita bela kucing, kucing ni akan mengiau dengan kita. Maksudnya, adakah kucing kita anggap kita ni macam anak diorang yang tak pandai-pandai dan tak ada bulu sangat? Sebab kalau ikutkan research, kucing dewasa hanya mengiau dekat kita, dekat manusia, untuk bercakap dengan kita. Jadi saya punya pendapat, dia macam ni tau. Kucing ni mengiau untuk dapatkan perhatian kita dengan mengajuk kita akhirnya. Bayangkan kalau seni kucing dia cakap macam, "Miau, aku manusia, aku bercakap miau." What? Ismail Jamil.